SchoolFreeware's free Pascal program tutorials. Tutorial 11, preventing crashes with Val. As many of you have found out, your programs will crash when incompatible data is entered into a numeric data type. We can use the Eval function to check for non-compatible data and then prevent that data from going into the numeric data type. The Eval function can convert strings into numeric values. This is the eval function right here. We have eval, and then within parentheses, the string we wish to convert. In the examples that I will show you, the string will be the user input. By trying to convert the user input into our numeric variable, we will find out if it goes into the variable or not. The computer will return an error, in which case we will put that error into a variable. If the error is equal to zero, then we know that everything went well and the string's data or the user input is compatible. If the error is not equal to zero, then we know that something went wrong, and therefore we know that the string's data or the user input is not compatible with what we're trying to do. The code used within this tutorial can be downloaded at schoolfreeware.com. A new program has already been created. The code to make the computer stop has been placed. I'll make a little program that will ask the user for an integer, and then simply print the integer up there on the screen. So I'm going to need a variable. I'll have num as an integer. I'll then write to the screen, prompting the user to enter an integer. I'll read line into num. Write line, your number, and then num. Okay, so when I go ahead and run, the computer accepts an integer, for example, 5. If I were to run this again and put in something other than an integer, like a W, immediately the program will crash. If I were to run this again and try to enter in a floating point number, like 4.5. Again, the program will crash. So what I need to do is put some input validation into this program using the val function. So I'm going to need a couple more variables. Error, which will hold the error from the val function. The error will be an integer. And I'm also going to need user input, so I'll make a variable called user input. And user input will be a string. We'll convert this string into the num. If the data is compatible with the integer, then the error should be equal to zero. If not, then these two are not compatible. So now what I'm going to do is make some modifications to this program. I'm going to repeat until error equals zero. I'm going to get rid of this num here for reline, and I'm just going to put the user input. The user input is a string, so I'm going to need to convert this with the val function. Val user input comma, then the variable I wish to place the user input into, which will be num, and then the error code, which will be placed in the variable called error. Okay, so when error is equal to zero, then we know that these two are compatible, and therefore we can print out the number here because the user input string has been converted into num. Before I go ahead and run the program, I am going to highlight these three lines and do a little house cleaning by indenting the selection, so now everything is easier to read. Okay, so let's try this out. Go ahead, run. Enter an integer, 5. That is correct. I'll go ahead and run. Let's try 4.5. Won't accept until I put it into an integer like 3. Okay, let's go ahead and try for a string. Let's go make a little modification to this program and try this with a real. So I'm going to make num as a floating point, real, data type. Instead of having enter an integer, we'll have enter a number. I'll make a little modification here, 0, 2. So we're printing out the floating point with two decimal places, 4.5. Let's try with a integer. That should still also work. So this takes it to as 2.00, which is fine. And let's try this with a string. String is not accepted, but floating point is.